found something that was unique to do, which was, it's sound design. You see it in movies all the time. It's sound design, but sound design crafted into a song. And four songs into that writing, we wrote a song called The Adventure. And that was a life-changing moment for me. We put some rocks in a shoebox, and we rolled the shoebox around with all these pebbles. And then we grabbed that and created a rhythm out of it. And so when we added some stomps and this rolling box of rocks, it created this grindy kind of rhythm. And then we added a riff to it that was a very simple riff, kind of sad sounding. But I didn't know what I was going to play for the main song, so we started with the rhythm, then put a riff, and I was like, okay, so where does it go from here? So I stomped on the pedal in time, and I was for hours straight sitting at the computer, and I think there's footage of this, of the documentary we made. Maybe you can show it right here.
Where does this need to go? Building. Bring in some rhythms underneath that thing, but it's what happened right here is what's throwing me for a loop.
Right.
If we go into some other
kind of... I'm sitting at the computer, and it just kind of starts to happen. Here, it's a little dry on the song. In the moment, it was something that gave you the chills up and down your arms. And I remember stopping and looking at Critter, and I was like, holy shit, holy shit, we got something. I remember during writing the words, actually, because I had a friend whose wife left him. Just figured that she can find something better, and he loved her. I remember him saying, I don't know if you'll ever know what it's like to love somebody so much more than they will ever love you, is what he said to me. So I remember feeling so beat up from everything I was going through with the whole Blink situation and trying to find a new identity and all that kind of stuff. And then my friend says that to me, and I was like, fuck then. We're gonna make a song that makes you feel like you can conquer the world. That night, after I sang it, I remember sitting in the studio at 2 a.m. It was at my house, my family's asleep, and I was listening to this thing, and about halfway this song, I had these tears in my eyes, and I felt like there was something magical happening. That happens to me every once in a while, where I'm a part of something artistically where I get kind of overwhelmed emotionally and feel like I'm really on to something that's important. Not that I think it's like great or better than anything else, or that it's gonna be something giant or big. It's because I feel like it touches on something that's important to me, and it like grabbed a hold of like a nerve, and it's just gripping it, and I could feel it, and it's like electric waves through your body. And it doesn't happen on every single thing, but it happens every so often, and you kind of go, wow, this is what I was meant to do, was this one little thing, and that song was one of them.